Hey y'all, I'm Heather Burge, and I'm so excited to share with you today some tips on how to take a dream teamy to an artist simply by doing the next right thing. So I am here to tell you that if you're like me, it can seem really overwhelming to grow a big team starting with your front line, right? But if you have big goals in this business, or you know you want to reach those top ranks, it does, or even just the next rank beyond elite or artist too, it's going to involve you building your team, right? So one of the reasons that we often have fear around this is we tend to think too big, right? Like we think of all the conversations we have to have. We think of what that entire conversation is going to look like with that person. What is she going to say? What is she going to ask? What do I do when this happens? When in reality, all we really need to do is the next right thing. And we also have to realize that pretty much every artist that joins your team or has joined anyone's team in the past has gone through a very similar looking funnel, which I'll share a picture of this as I kind of talk through it. But first of all, I'd love to know how many of you guys are Frozen 2 fans. There are so many little nuggets of wisdom in there. And one of the things that really resonated with me is something that I also learned in Habit Finder training, which is the power of when you don't know what to do, you just simply do the next right thing. And I think sometimes we try to, you know, control the end result by getting our, you know, putting the cart before the horse or getting ahead of ourselves with the fear of what could happen. When in reality, the conversations with your dream teamies, they're going to look different with every single one of them. And even though this is a numbers game, and I'm going to talk a little bit about that, it really is always quality over quantity, right? Like you, our comp plan and our business model and the joy that you're going to have in business is always going to come from having the people that you really want to do this business with be the ones that join your team. So I have always called those dream teamies. So what I want to share is, first of all, the elements that make up a dream teamy and how to even know if someone qualifies to be a dream teamy. And they can be a customer. They don't have to be a customer. We'll talk about that funnel in just a minute. But first of all, there are three C's that will define every dream teamy. And I actually learned this from one of my amazing leaders, Lauren Verlander. So I got to give her amazing props for sharing this because it's so brilliant. But the three C's on how to know if somebody would make a great Saint artist is are they coachable? So for example, if they're hosting a class for you, or you know, if they are a potential customer, did they send the no makeup selfie like you asked them to? Did they engage in the group and take your advice on how to have it be a successful class? Basically, do they do what you tell them to do? Are they coachable? Do they listen to you? One of the little tips that I use in my business is when I check in with a customer to see how they're liking their makeup, if they say they love it, I'll say, oh my goodness, send me a before and after. I'd love to see it. And something as simple as that one little next step is going to tell me a lot about whether or not they would be a great fit to be put on my dream teamy list, if you will. So are they coachable? Number two is, are they connected? So connected doesn't have to look like a million followers on Instagram, though certainly that could be a good thing. But is it someone who's connected in their community, maybe connected in their church? Is it someone who, you know, maybe has a circumstance in their life, like maybe a special needs child or a skill set or something that they're passionate about where they are part of a community that are aligned in that? If so, someone who is connected even with, you know, has built a good level of trust within a community that is out there, they would be a great fit for you because they've already built that trust and that connection with their tribe, and they're going to really resonate when she shares the power of this makeup or the power of this business model. So is your dream teamy connected? The third C is going to be confident. So think about how many people you know that already are, you know, comfortable putting themselves out there. So, you know, maybe it is someone who already is snapping selfies on their feed, or maybe they go live for their business and that's not something that makes them nervous. Or, you know, even if they're afraid, because it's, I mean, shoot, Tammy, my biggest leader, she didn't go live until she had influencer. So I'm not saying they have to, you know, put themselves out there in that way, but Tammy exudes a quiet confidence that's very evident for anybody that knows her. And part of that comes from her wisdom of, you know, being 50 plus. So that certainly is going to look different for everybody. But the key element and the key tying element to that dream team equality is she confident? So once you know that someone is, whether or not they're a customer or an artist, or I'm sorry, customer or not, are they coachable? Are they connected? Are they confident? I want you to make a list of those dream teamies. And you should always have this as an ongoing list. This is something that I write it down in my planner. I update it, if not monthly, every several months. I have my dream teamie list. And everyone on that is, you know, embodies those three C's. And about, this is kind of an interesting metric, that about 1 in 10 of your customers is, if not more, is wanting to join you in the business. So starting from your customer base, if you don't know where to start, is a great place to start. If they're not a customer, often the next right thing for them is going to be to invite them to become a customer. So that's going to look like inviting them to a contour class or to an event you're having, or to do in-person makeover, to let them borrow, you borrow their face so that you can practice if you're brand new. And certainly, it's really just guiding them to that next element or that next thing that's going to intrigue them to try the makeup. So if they're not a customer and you want them to join your team, often that next right thing is just inviting them to become a customer. So I, again, on my little funnel chart, knowing that 1 in 10 of your customers will likely want to join you in your business, and knowing that that's a great place to start, I encourage every single one of you to go to your back office and pull up your customer list. And I want you to think about each and every name, no excuses. Some of them might bring that little like fear or nervousness into your heart. It happens to me too, actually all the time. But I want you to, without question, if she fits those three C's, write that name down, make a list. If you are new, or maybe that list is not, you know, super large, certainly go outside of your customer base, you guys. 1 in 3 artists joined without trying the makeup. So people join this business all the time without trying it. It absolutely can happen. So certainly start by, who do you know out there that embodies those three C's? Who of your high school besties, who of your family, your cousins, maybe it's even your mom or your sister or your sister-in-law, who do you know that embodies that? And again, without question, write their name down on that list. And then your next step, once you've made your list from your customers and your not customers, I recommend always having a list of no less than 10, if not 30 or 50 women at all times. Just have their names written down. I want you to make another column right next to it that says next. And instead of all of the excuses that you might have, or getting ahead of yourself of thinking, well, what do I do when she does this? Or what do I say if she asks this question? Instead, I want you to identify that next right thing that is right for that customer. If it's somebody that you haven't talked to in a long time, guess what that next right thing is? Picking up the phone and checking on them. If it's a customer that hasn't ordered in about a year, check in on her and see if she's still using the makeup, if she needs the right colors. Hey, are you still using this thing? If it's a new customer, check in on her and see how she's liking the makeup. Ask her to send you a before and after, see what happens. If she is a customer and she's loving the makeup, invite her to host a class or even just a curiosity post, which is basically just putting it out there on social media, maybe a before and after that she sent to you, and just saying, hey, I don't even sell this, but my friend Heather does, and she can hook you up with a free color match if you're interested. And those are powerful next steps that can build that confidence and vision for how this business could be not only so much fun and fulfilling, but truly something that could impact and change their life. So look at that funnel and imagine that, you know, the law of averages says that you've got to swing the bat a bunch of times before you hit the ball, right? But the more that you swing the bat, the more you practice anything, and that includes having better conversations with more people, you will start to see a pattern emerge in your own business within that averages. And you're going to have a lot of conversations to get there, but don't let that overwhelm you. Just start with that next name on your dream teamie list and do the next right thing for her. Use your voice, use your heart, share with whatever it is that you know is the right next step for her. And with that, you will build and grow your team. So I hope this has been helpful. Can't wait to expound on this a little more, and definitely check out that funnel and know that likely again that your journey and your Saint Mama's journey probably looks very similar to that, and that can be really helpful in terms of drilling down the next right thing for your dream teamie. So yay!